Hey guys, so I'm here today. This is like the first video I'm filming actually in 2022, so this is crazy. I got COVID, went on like a small family vacation, everything like that. So yeah, finally in the midway of January, I'm finally filming a video. I wanted to share with you how much I made on YouTube in a full year. I have my analytics pulled up here. I'm gonna be showing you all my analytics, how much I made, some tips that you can use for your channel, everything like that. So let's get into it. I've done a video kind of like this of how much I made on YouTube in a month. You can see it here. The links will be down below as well as up here. And then also a video of how much I made in 6 months. Everyone who starts on YouTube, it takes a little bit. So once you finally start making money, you're like, oh my gosh, like I'm making money for my videos that I've been doing for free all of this time. So I think that's super cool. I think it's cool that I feel like YouTube, out of all of the apps that I've seen, have the best analytic breakdown. So I love doing that. You guys will be able to see all my analytics to kind of compare to yours. I'm going to be telling you, like I said, tips of what you can do while I'm showing you my analytics. So many juicy big things in this video. The answer that you've all been waiting for. How much did I make in 1 year on YouTube? I made $1,000 and like 97. So I think that's super cool. That's definitely more than I've ever made on social media because this is the first thing that I've gotten monetized on and have had it for the longest. Technically, I guess Facebook, I have made a lot of money off that, but for my first social media that's gotten monetized for a full year, $1,000 is a lot, especially like I said, when you've been making them for free for such a long time. So I think a lot of things had to deal with my growth. I'm definitely staying with it, posting content that people want to see versus the ones that I just think would be fun to make, which is hard sometimes. Obviously, as a content creator, you have the freedom to do whatever you want, but you also have to stay in the realm of like, what are people gonna wanna watch? And have like a business mindset with it as well. So people can actually get to your videos versus you just posting something and getting like 10 views on it. Obviously, you gotta start somewhere. But what will actually grow your channel is you like niching down, focusing on what people are wanting to see, and just staying consistent, I think, is like the biggest 3 tips that I would have. I have a whole bunch of other YouTube growth videos too that you can watch. I'll link them all down below. So check down below when you're done watching this. There'll be a plethora of videos to watch. So yeah, the biggest thing is just get videos out there that people want to see versus the ones that you just want to make. I know it's hard, but it is what it is. That's why, like, do a nice combination. Obviously, you can do videos that you really like. I would say like 90-10, like do 10% of the videos that you really like making that may not get the most views. Growth type videos that you think is gonna help grow your channel. Okay, so let me show you my screen. Let me pull it up. And as you can see on my channel, if you ever browse through it, I'm really big on like social media growth and just like showing my life, things like that, helping you guys make money on social media as well. So that's kind of my niche. I really niche down though on my TikTok and other social medias with target content. So my YouTube's kind of just like a back end for that to help people grow their social medias too, stuff like that. I do post my target shorts and reels on here too, but my main social medias are for Target. This social media is more for like the growth. Obviously, I do a lot of Target tips too on this channel, stuff like that. So it's an interesting social media plan that I have, but it works. Another really big tip that I have is create content on your page that can be evergreen as well as viral. So what I mean by that is evergreen are videos that can be looked up no matter what year it is, no matter how long that video has been out there. So like I say, how to create a YouTube video or how to grow your YouTube, that's always going to be a hot topic and that's always going to be relevant. So that's going to be a type of video that can stay on my channel and still grow, create money for me for a long time, no matter what time it is. And then viral can be like my mascara video about TikTok, which grew super quickly at the beginning and when I first posted it and kind of like drifted off as time goes by. That one helped my channel bring a lot of people, a lot of eyeballs, subscribers, everything like that. But that was a viral video that I knew would not have a shelf life super long, but it's good to have like a combination of them. Also, like I say, a combination of like stories about you so people can actually get to know you, things like that, and relate to you. I think that's super important. So those are like 3 types of content that I would always say it helps is viral, educational about you and stuff, and then also the evergreen content. They can kind of intermingle, but that's kind of like the top 3 that I always try to keep my videos within. Okay, so as you can see on my channel analytics, I switched it to just January 1st to December 31st, 2021. So you can see the full year instead of like having some of January in it, other year, stuff like that. So as you can see right here, I got 705,000 views on my channel. I got 9.7k watch time, plus 926 subscribers, which is pretty cool because that's almost 1,000. And then your estimated revenue for the year. So what I really love about YouTube analytics, it breaks it down like this. I feel like these are the top ones you should always be looking at because obviously these are the main points of your channel. Like if you're not getting watch time on your channel, you won't be getting subscribers. Obviously, if you're not getting watch time, you won't be getting views. So it all intermingles. And then all of this adds up to your estimated revenue. So it all is very important. I like the overview they have on here. As you can see, like some of my videos in December did really well. But then it's going to be saying your top videos in this period, which is also super great to look at. So this PS5 in stock at Target short I posted got 88,000 views. This viral TikTok mascara that I was mentioning got 86,000. That's a longer form content, so I made a good amount of money on that. You can't technically at this point make money on reels / shorts on YouTube yet. You can get bonuses and stuff from your shorts, but they're not counting it as monetization, all of that stuff, when you reach that goal. Also, monetization requirements that I want to share with you are 4,000 hours of watch time, and that's hours, and 1,000 subscribers. So just note that if you're close, you obviously can check it on your analytics and monetization right here, and then you can see how close you are, or if you're already monetized, you already know how that goes. So that's important to know that, so you know the requirements. They haven't changed that for the past couple years, so I'm assuming they're gonna keep that for a while. And then you can see just like the other videos that do well and did well in 2021. Obviously you can see that some of these videos were posted in 2020, and that's what I'm talking about, having content that can be on your page for a long time. So this how to get a job at Target tips, it was posted in 2020, but it's still getting views. So that's a good evergreen type video. Obviously, this viral video is going to do well and it's going to be on the top because it got so many views. But I would like to see how it compares to the Target one compared to like how many traffic I got throughout its lifetime. So you can see all the info in that. And then reach is very important to look at because this is how people are actually seeing your videos. So impressions means, okay, they look at your video. Do I stop to look at it? Stuff like that. So I got 2.6 million impressions. And then out of those people, how many of those people actually click on your video is the click-through rate. And that is 8.6%, which is all these are in the green, which is really good. That's what you want. And then you can see your traffic sources. And then you also can see, oh no, it's in audience. You can see if more females or males are watching your page, stuff like that, which I think is interesting. You can see what time it is good to post, so you can kind of post your videos within the peak times. But yeah, here's the top geographies in the United States because I speak English, so I wouldn't think any less. And then down here is female, male, age, and then how much are subscribed and not subscribed. It really is crazy. A lot of people who aren't subscribed to you will watch your videos versus the subscribed, so I think that's interesting. Obviously, that doesn't really matter too much, but age and gender can be important to you because if you're posting, like, different types of videos, you can see what age range it's really hitting. Obviously, if you're, like, a huge business channel, this will help you so you can sell your products to the correct people and the correct age group. I think it's interesting that, like, female and male are very equal. I feel like last year it wasn't like that, or even in, like, my 6-month video, it wasn't like that either. But yeah, so I think that's interesting. And then revenue, you can see obviously your revenue of how much it's grown. In January 1st, this is kind of when I posted my viral TikTok mascara video. So that one is where I had huge peak times. You can see a peak time right here. And during the holidays, I feel like it's always a good time. And then in January, sometimes it does like dwindle off, but that's okay. That's why a lot of people I heard take breaks then. I think it's just very interesting to look at the breakdown. And then here's the breakdown of the months as well instead of just in a full year. So here's in January, February, March, April, obviously all the way until December, and you can see how much you made through that. I think I just love how much they break down your content. And so yeah, that's how much I made. I really think it's important to know that you do not need any fancy equipment to get started on YouTube. You can literally start with your iPhone and a window. So definitely do not let any self-doubt, any imposter syndrome get onto you and saying, oh my god, people are going to watch these videos and think they're so bad. Like, no, I don't care because I'm making money off the videos and I'm doing something I like. And if someone wants to hate you for doing something you like, that's more on them than on you, because at least you're enjoying life. Obviously, they're not if they want to hate on you. So definitely keep doing what you're doing, or start if you've been scared to. You got this. And just really look at my tip videos. That's helped a lot. Obviously, like I said, have a good combination of videos on your channel, and just don't do the ones that you love doing. Do ones that you think that people will like to watch as well as you like doing, obviously. Create videos that you like doing, but then that can also make you stand out from the competition. There's thousands, if not millions, of videos being posted on YouTube a day. So what can you do to make your video stand out? I think thumbnails are also a very big thing. Thumbnails are the first things people see, so if they're not engaging, if you can't see yourself, all those things, I have actually a video of how to create a like engaging thumbnail, so check that out too if you have problems with creating your thumbnail. I make mine completely for free on Canva, and I got all these views, all this money by making it on a free website, so you can do it too. It doesn't take any fancy equipment for that either, any fancy editing. And I'm just so excited to keep on this journey. I hit monetization requirements about a month or two ago on TikTok, and then I made some money on Facebook. So I just see this growing more than I could ever imagine. This is finally like what I wanted. I wanted to finally make money on social media, and it's finally here. I'm super excited for 2022. And yeah, it's a hard game out there sometimes, because you compare yourself countless of times to other creators, to other people, and you're like, oh my god, they have this many subscribers, I don't, they're making this much money, I'm not. And it's just, your time will come if you keep pushing, doing the correct things to make you grow online and all of that stuff. So I guess that's really all I have. I'm excited for the future, and I'm very proud of myself of how much I made so far on YouTube, because YouTube is like the first thing I started out. I did it in high school just for fun, and now finally making money off of it is super cool to see. And if you guys have any questions, feel free to comment below or DM me on Instagram, just Caitlin Sunday. But yeah, I guess that's all of the video. I know this was a super jam-packed video, but I'm excited to see what the future brings. I'm doing a lot of social media growth, kind of doing TikTok videos too, saying like how I grew, tips for you guys, all of that stuff. So definitely stay tuned for that on my channel. I have some big brand deals I want to be sharing with you as well that I'm excited about, and that's kind of what my 2022 is about. It's obviously still growing, but I really want to get into brand deals and like creating money through that, and just working with cool brands that I love. So super excited. So I'll see you guys in my next video, and hope you guys are having a great day. Bye guys.